lot of parents would like to think they could change a teen's behavior, but it's probably more important to understand a teen's behavior. One of the things I think that's really important for parents to always keep in mind is that teenagers aren't miniature adults, and they often do need the same sort of structures and boundaries and guidance that a 4 or 5-year-old might need. The way the brain matures is in such a way that kind of from the back to the front, from the inside out. So the teenagers in the midst, their flight or flight responses, the emotional part of their brain, which is called the limbic system, is well and truly mature long before the frontal lobes, and particularly the right prefrontal cortex, which sits behind the right eye. Now, that's really important because it's that region of the brain that allows us to make responsible decisions, allows us to do abstract thinking, allows us to regulate our emotions. And through the teenagers, it's going through a major restructuring process. So what we know is that teenagers are generally hotwired for emotion, and that kind of runs like a car where the emotions, they accelerate, but the brakes, the frontal lobes, just aren't working. And so more often than not, what you have are young people who are hotwired for emotion, but often will do things that might make a 5-year-old cringe in disbelief. It's important for parents to keep in mind that they have to find the balance between allowing their young person to be an independent young person, but also the support and guidance to help make sure that they don't make mistakes as they traverse through adolescence and the teenage years.
You can discover more on the Spark Their Future website.